Everybody, my name is Cameron, and today I'll be doing a video on high performance habits, how extraordinary people become that way, part two. So, part two, that means I did a video a while ago. I was talking about how bad stuff, why you shouldn't do bad stuff, how you should have good habits, and I talked about courage. Did I talk about influence?
No.
Oh. These habits right here. You need to get a good habit to have courage, a good habit to be influenced by good things, by good subjects, not bad stuff. Don't get influenced by drugs. You have to have a good habit of productivity, necessity, energy, and clarity. Energy especially. Because I'm always hyper. I don't need to have it anymore. I need to calm down. Everybody says I'm way too talkative. And one of my friend's mom, I was hanging out with him, and my friend Lukey told me that when I wasn't looking, his mom told him that he's really talkative. And my friend told me that's not a good thing because she doesn't like talkative kids. I don't know. So. And good habits, such as influence is a way how you follow people, not just following them for fun, following them with a good purpose. Following them for a good purpose, that means following them. You watch their videos, you learn how to invest. Good. Following them, fall off a bridge, punch each other, watch porn. Bad influence. There are differences between good and bad influences, and it's a good habit to be influenced. But if you don't know when it's coming, and you get influenced by bad subject, and you don't know, it's still bad, but not as bad if you do it purposefully. He was like, you have the intention of watching porn, but accidentally watch porn. You're like, hey, I want to show you a cool video. I'm like, yeah, and he just turns it on. But if you're like, hey, you want to watch this? I'm like, oh, sure, I definitely want to. Those are the two differences. Where you don't know what it is, and you didn't. And you get influenced by them by accident or purpose. So, good habits, such as following your New Year's resolution, which I did earlier today when I was driving down the hill with a bumper car. And this is like my previous video. You should really watch it. So, and you need a good habit. I want to have a good habit of doing that every day so I could continue doing videos and completing my schedule around 11 o'clock. Oh, 11 o'clock. And it's a good habit when I do stuff and follow my goals schedule. Like I did today, and I'll continue the habit of, okay, here's my schedule I need to continue doing. Here's a day for us, go to sleep, wake up. I woke up at 7 today. I got up, brushed my teeth, read, did not eat breakfast. I just started reading. I did eat breakfast around 12, that's more of lunch. And I went to read. I went to for an hour. I went to go write. I went to do a few videos. I went to the park. My mom had to put on her makeup for it took an hour. I got lunch at Starbucks. I went to the park, came back, all my schedule's done. I did a few math problems and reading for half an hour or so. And then I ended up playing for an hour, and I ended up doing this video now, and after this, I'm going to Dave and Buster's. It's going to have a fun time. So, I need to continue that good habit. Good habits, good work pays off. Hard work pays off. Not always. Slave. Hard work. Ugh. Now can I have my raise? No. You're getting paid less. So, hard work doesn't always pay off. Hard labor especially doesn't. Did he know that if you're doing a good habit, you get easier labor instead of harder. And easier labor always makes you get paid more. The easier the labor, the more you get paid. Because it's like you pick up trash, hard labor, dumping stuff. Hard labor, you get paid 10 bucks an hour, 20 bucks an hour. And then McDonald's, hard labor, stay there 24/7. But if you have other objects, such as like investing, you're sitting on a chair all day, like, all right, so do you want to trade this or this, right? Wow, you're earning millions or earning 20 bucks an hour picking up trash. So those are two differences, and I keep up this good habit, I'll end up being an investor. And good habits are not any ordinary habits. But this book is not about good habits. It's about high performance habits. High performance, that means hardworking. Hardworking, not all hardworking is good, but some. You work hard in the beginning, you build up, then you become rich. So that's the only way you can work it. Don't think that you'll always be easy, because it isn't. Because you can see how I'm having fun right now. It took hard work to get it off. I woke up in the morning at 7 o'clock, got straight there. That's hard work. And now I'm gonna enjoy my time and go to Dave & Buster's. I'm going to Dave & Buster's, this is like very rare. I don't go to this that many times. Just because my friend and my brother went, my mom kind of felt bad for me. So she became awesome and decided to take me. So, high performance habits, such as going to the gym, which I want to do, but, I mean, the last time that happened, my brother ended up, because we were on the treadmill, I was moving at like 5 miles per hour at sprint, I was like, until my brother was like, and he was going like 1 mile per hour on the treadmill, and he was like, let me see this. So, and you know what he did? He's supposed to do this. He went step on, but instead he did this. Because he didn't move at all. And he